Hey Star Wars fans, another FlyGuy.net figure review. This is an older figure, one which I'm actually letting go and giving to a friend, and I thought before this goes, I'll let you guys have a look at it, as the figure is fairly rare in some ways and fairly hard to come by. It's from the Force Unleashed original wave of figures, which was in the 30th anniversary collection, and the figure is Ram Kota. If you've ever played any of the Force Unleashed games, this this Jedi General appears in both games, but we've only had one version of him in terms of a figure so far. We've yet to see any Force Unleashed 2 figures, which I believe we will next year. So looking at this figure, just before I really swithered in whether to let this guy go, because even though he was part of what I think is an excellent collection, the 30th anniversary collection, and it's fairly old, this guy came with every point of articulation just about going. It really was not a bad figure at all. He would stand up to the test, and I would imagine could very comfortably be recarded into the vintage collection as part of an expanded universe kind of collection or something under the Force Unleashed and sell pretty well. So let me put the stand down, which came with all those figures in the previous versions and was stamped with the expanded universe one. So a quick look at Ram, just as I kind of close up on him. And again, if you're new to our channel, you can watch these in high def and you can really zoom in and see the detail if you want to. So first off, the thing that strikes you, the face sculpt is not very game accurate, but like it's doing the job. It's certainly a brand new facial sculpt from Hasbro, and one that certainly is pretty good. He comes with, the first time I've ever seen it on a figure, a ponytail all bunched up there, his little bunch tail, or whatever you want to call that kind of thing. And the coolest thing that jumps out, and I have to show you first of all, is this almost like a ninja sword kind of piece on his back. Now, unfortunately, this seems a little daft, as it's there for the lightsaber to go in the back, which fits perfectly. But if you're like me, you're questioning, isn't he going to burn his butt with the lightsaber? Or in fact, isn't it going to slice through this holster? So, it's a little bit of an odd piece, really, but I guess in the game you had this, and the lightsaber helps fit into it, but they don't give you any difference in the lightsaber. There is no detachable blade there, so it's really all one piece, so it doesn't quite work in some ways. But look, it's a cool looking thing and quite different, so we'll just suspend belief and we'll just assume that it's some wonderful Jedi thing that doesn't melt its way through that, and his butt isn't getting singed. But cool figure all over, comes with great articulation. He's got ball jointed head, ball jointed, well in fact they're not ball jointed, even though they're kind of, they almost could be if it wasn't for this piece here, but they are in fact swivel shoulders, ball jointed elbows though, and these swivel forearms as well. Got a swivel waist, and he's got swivel hips, ball jointed knees, and for an older figure, ball jointed ankles. So a very cool figure in that sense. So the armor is removable. It's a bit of a complex kind of situation to get it off, but if I quickly try to peel some of this back, you'll see there's a clip at the back there of his belt, which just simply comes undone. And then if I hold it up here, you'll see, I won't take it all off, but you'll see under the he's just completely plain underneath the armour on his chest. It's just a brown flat tunic and there's nothing else to it. So not much to show you there. So he looks far, far cooler with the armour on him anyway, and again that just clips back on the back and on like so. He does have these very strange, it's not quite a Jedi cloak, but it's pieces of a Jedi cloak tucked into under his underarms and through this holster. So they sit a little oddly when the figure is kind of standing, but I guess it looks pretty cool. The best part seems to be this armor that he has on his chest plate, very like the ATAT commanders or some kind of earlier ATAT commanders that they used to have with that kind of chest plate on them. So not a great deal else I can tell you about this figure. It seems to be fairly rare, as a lot of the Force Unleashed figures are on eBay. It's just one which I've loved for a long time, but well, I'm making room for lots of more new cool figures, so I thought I'd pass this on to a friend and let it go. So there we go, Force Unleashed Ram Kota. If you've never seen this figure before, he certainly is cool, and I urge you, if you've never collected anything from the 30th anniversary collection, go back and have a look at some of those figures. We reviewed Obi-Wan Kenobi from Mustafar just recently, and it was a brilliant figure, coming with some great looking articulation on the figure there, and there were some great gems in the 30th anniversary collection, including some other reviews we've got up there, some of the Macquarie vintage looking kind of a concept figures. So great looking collection, and Ram Kota is pretty cool, even if he does have a very odd ninja lightsabery kind of thing on his back, but one you might want to pick up if you can find. So there we go, stay tuned for some more reviews and let us know what you think in the comments below, and as usual on facebook.com/flyguy.net. See you soon.